What's up, dudes, and what's up, ladies? Bryan here, and in this video, we are going to look at minerals. This video is going to be a general overview. I will be posting individual mineral videos in the near future. In this video, we're going to look at what minerals are, the degree at which they are absorbed, and the two groups they are divided into. So, let's roll. Minerals are inorganic substances, meaning that they're not derived by living matter, that are needed in trace to small amounts to help regulate bodily functions, such as assisting with muscle contraction and regulating enzyme activity. Nearly all minerals, with the exception of iron, are absorbed in their free form. In most cases, when minerals are bound to other molecules, the mineral absorption is impaired. Also, mineral-mineral interactions can interfere with how well minerals are absorbed. One example is that iron supplementation may decrease the ability of the body to absorb zinc. This is worth noting when considering taking mineral supplements. The degree at which a mineral can be absorbed is known as its bioavailability. High mineral bioavailability can be categorized when greater than 40% of the mineral can be absorbed. The minerals included in this category are chloride, fluoride, iodine, potassium, and sodium. Minerals that have low bioavailability, that less than 10%, include chromium, iron, manganese, and zinc. All other minerals have a bioavailability of 30 to 40%. The minerals that the body needs are called essential minerals. There are 16 of them, which I have listed on the screen. These can be divided into two groups, macrominerals and microminerals. Macrominerals are major elements and include calcium, chloride, magnesium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, and sulfur. These elements have recommended daily intake of 100 milligrams per day or more for adults. Microminerals are trace minerals and include chromium, copper, fluoride, iodine, iron, manganese, molybdenum, selenium, and zinc. Of these trace elements, the only ones that have established recommended daily intake are iodine, iron, selenium, and zinc. Bottom line time. A great approach is to consume a balanced diet that contains a variety of nutrient-dense foods that are not highly processed. That can provide the body with the essential minerals. Alright, if you have any questions or comments, you can leave them below. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up. If you didn't like the video, hit the thumbs down. Till next time, I'm out. See ya.